6 this morning. Law enforcement calls it an international organized crime network, a ring headquartered in 2 Eastern European countries, but operating right here in our state.
Louisiana Attorney General just filed racketeering charges against 4 members of that organization and estimates that the number of victims is now in the hundreds, and the money involved is in the hundreds of millions of dollars.
WDSU News reporter Rosa Flores breaks down the tactics used by these alleged criminals. She has another story you will see only on 6.
Sit up. Sit up.
Donna Angel found cute little JR on the internet.
Good boy.
So when a bargain for an F-150 popped up on a local website.
Here it is. They have the classified ad.
She didn't think much of it and responded to the ad by email.
So he let me know I could check on the vehicle.
And she did check. Not just the integrity of the VIN number, but she cross-checked the name of the owner with the use of the truck.
Being used, had all changed at a dealership, had the track of everywhere it's been. So it made sense that, okay, this sounds believable.
The supposed owner responded quickly and said he'd like to seal the deal through the eBay vehicle purchase program because it was simply safe and secure. Take a close look at the invoice, the logo, the copyright, and the email address of the representative, Dimitrov. It all looks legitimate, but after wiring $12,000, Angel found out this eBay vehicle purchase program isn't related to the eBay auction website.
You're just so destroyed. You just can't believe it happened.
The deputy director of the Office of the Louisiana Attorney General says Angel is one of hundreds of victims around the country, duped by members of a sophisticated international crime network headquartered in Romania and Moldova.
You have the crime bosses in these countries, and then over here you have these different cells of people who are called arrows, and they're like runners. You know, they'll go to the bank, set up an account, withdraw the cash.
Remember Dimitar Dimitrov, the supposed eBay representative who emailed Angel? Caldwell says Dimitrov is an alleged runner, now charged for racketeering.
And in fact, it's so sophisticated that they have a customer service email address at the bottom, a security address. But it's their own security address, so you're calling the criminal and asking them, is it okay to send the money?
Hundreds of victims have wired millions of dollars. That's why Caldwell wants to send a clear message that in Louisiana, racketeering carries a penalty of up to 50 years in prison.
You get a few of these guys visiting Angola, that's going to send a very powerful, powerful message. Angola is not a fun place to be. I promise you they will find out about it in Romania. Word will get around, and it'll cause some people to think twice.
So far, Caldwell has linked 3 other suspects to what he calls a keen criminal organization, all arrested while withdrawing cash from a bank and all charged for racketeering. As for JR, he protects Angel from the dangerous spins of the World Wide Web. Now, eBay says that the transactions on their website do not happen through email, and it also says that sellers are not allowed to ask buyers to seal the deal through wire transfers, that is simply not safe. Now, WDSU also received a statement from eBay. Take a look at your screen. It says, unfortunately, fraudsters try to find ways to trick internet users by exploiting eBay's name, logo, and reputation to lure them off of safe and secure e-commerce sites such as eBay. We commend the authorities for taking action to combat this illegal activity and protect consumers. Now, here are the mugshots of the 4 suspects charged with racketeering. Dimitar Dimitrov, Radu Manolachi, Ion Antohi, and Andrei Golovko all are expected to face a judge in the next few months. Now, Caldwell also says that some of the victims he contacted didn't even know that they had fallen victim. You see, there's a time gap between when a person orders a vehicle, when they order the wire transfer, and when that wire transfer actually goes through. So some of the folks that they contacted were in that time lapse. These folks, at least one victim, contacted their bank at that point in time, interrupted the wire transfer, and was able to get their money back. So the message from the Attorney General this morning is, If you believe that you've been duped, you want to call your bank immediately. Hopefully, you'll be able to get your money back. That's the latest here from the CBD. I'm Rosa Flores for WDSU News.
All right, Rosa, thank you for that. And so far, the dealings of the four suspects can be traced to East Baton Rouge Parish, Iberia Parish, Tensaw Parish, and Jefferson Parish. Again, if you feel you have fallen victim, contact the Louisiana Attorney General, and you could just go to WDSU.com to figure out how to do that. And we have a quick link for you to his